joined today by Bob Damon, who's going to talk to me about the Quincy History and Heritage Roadshow at the Crane, happening on November 27th at 7 o'clock. Bob, thanks so much for joining us today.
Yeah, well, thank you for having me, Clayton. It's great to be here with you.
Super excited that we are doing this project. I know it's a project you've been working on for quite some time.
It is, yeah. We've been working on some research and understanding Quincy's history and heritage for about 18 months now.
Yep.
And by we, I mean I've been working directly with the mayor's office. So what we're doing here in the History and Heritage Roadshow is a part of a larger initiative that's sponsored by the office of Mayor Tom Koch.
Well, there's certainly a lot to get into. So 18 months compared to the 400 years almost of history that we have seems relatively short, but I'm sure to you, and it's quite a project that you're working on. And I know I'm grateful and everybody's grateful to all the work that the mayor and you are putting into this. On the 27th, let's talk about what people can expect when they come over to the library.
Well, that's right. So the History and Heritage Roadshow is going to be at the Crane Library on November 27th. That's a Tuesday. We'll be here from 7 to around 8:30, so about 90 minutes. And what we're going to be doing is rolling in and talking a lot about Quincy's local historical heritage. This place is really amazing with regard to the amount of heritage it has here. So we're sitting here right in downtown Quincy. Within a mile of us here are 7 National Historic Landmarks, for example. There are 2,500 across the entire country. There are 7 within a mile of where we're sitting right now.
Within a mile.
Yes, yeah. But just so really remarkable.
And I know when we were talking before, you're not talking about the national parks even.
Oh, well, so that particular stat does include...
That does include the National
Parks. That does include the National Park Service here in Quincy.
Yeah.
You know, 5, not too bad.
That's still, within a mile, that's quite a bit.
That's right. Yeah. That's right. So we're here really as a part of an outreach initiative that's a part of the Quincy 400 initiative.
Okay.
So I'm using that word initiative a lot. So the Quincy 400, the mayor's program to reach out to the community and talk with people and get feedback and develop a collective vision for what do we want Quincy to be and look like at its 400th anniversary.
So we're looking back in order to look forward.
Well, in this case, yes, we are. And in this case, we're looking back at what are those pieces of Quincy's history that have been saved over time, right? We can almost think about this like it's almost like an archaeology project, right? So you mentioned 400 years worth of Quincy's history. Not all of that history has been saved along the way, but this community is incredibly fortunate to have a large number of pieces or slices of that history that have been saved at different times. And so what we're going to be doing is talking a lot about that historic heritage, talking a little bit about the difference between historic heritage and history itself. And then we're going to do it, get in the spirit of something full and participatory. So I don't want to give away too much, but we're going to be asking participants who come to the event to get into that history, quite literally get their hands dirty with some of that history.
And I'm sure a very comfortable way. There's nothing to be frightened of here.
No, absolutely not. Definitely not. And you don't have to be an expert. You don't have to know anything about Quincy's history in order to really be able to take advantage of this experience here at the library.
And it's going to focus this time, this stop on the roadshow is going to focus on the library, which I'm personally very proud of.
It is indeed. And that library, many people don't know, is one of the most important architectural buildings here in Quincy.
What I appreciate about that is how much it says about the city of Quincy. I mean, it's a gorgeous building, but to really appreciate it, you have to take it within the context of the values that Quincy embodied in this space. So I think that's... Maybe, I don't know if there's, it's, you know, all these remarkable historical sites, the fact that they have been, so many of them have been preserved, we do have such heritage, says something about the people in the community that have lived here in the city for so long.
Oh, agreed. And the fact that this is the Thomas Crane Memorial Library also talks about that level of mindfulness, you know, almost 200 years ago now, right? Folks who are really thinking about this city and this community in that same way that you were just describing, as they move forward with the efforts to build this really important community resource here.
Hmm. Are there examples of other communities that have embarked on similar kind of heritage quests, if you will, other kind of adventures in looking at their heritage that you are thinking about as you've been doing this work?
Well, here in Eastern Massachusetts, there are a lot of communities that are looking forward to and planning for their 400th anniversary, right? We have the 400th anniversary of Plymouth coming up in 2020. Mm-hmm. But in terms of doing the larger sort of historic heritage planning work, it's pretty cool to say that Quincy is one of the communities that's sort of out front on that process.
That is exciting.
And that's very exciting to think about. We have a lot to learn from our European friends across the ocean, who have been doing this kind of work for over 20 years in many cases, particularly in places like the UK and Ireland. And certain parts of Western Europe. So we have a lot of great examples of what kinds of things to do and that are really successful that we're going to be bringing here to the community as a part of that.
Well, that's really exciting. I think there's so much that will be uncovered as part of this process. I know that we have deep resources here at the library that I'm surprised pretty much every time I go in, there's something else that gets uncovered, and another stone that's turned where you see, wait, I didn't realize that tie or that connection. And I can't wait to hear all the personal stories. I know that there's so many people here in the city who personally have things, in their own personal family histories that are still unknown. So I think this is maybe the beginning of helping to share some of those with a wider audience.
Oh, absolutely, yeah. Again, this is really just a first step. And we're really hoping to build that awareness amongst new members of the community, mm-hmm. as well as those folks who have been here for generations. That's really the idea, is to really reinvigorate that interest in Quincy's historic heritage as we look forward to its 400th.
That's wonderful. And I know you're talking about the entire community. As we talk about new residents, we talk about the really rich, diverse history of the city. We have the presidential history, but we also had, immigrants that were coming from all over. We have a mural in our meeting room that talks about us being a city of immigrants. And I think that's a key piece to remind everyone as we're going through. This is not just for the families that relate, that trace themselves back to ships that came from Europe, but people who came from all over the world and made Quincy the city that it is.
Oh, absolutely. And again, this really is a process that we're engaging in now, right? Mm-hmm. So this really is a 21st century process of how do we take the legacies of those things that are really important to us and care for them and preserve them moving forward.
And it's about those values that we really have sustained us and how they're going to continue to fuel the world for our children, our grandchildren.
That is certainly the case.
Great.
Certainly the case, yeah.
Well, that's great. Thank you so much. I think it's going to be a fabulous evening on the 27th. We're going to learn a lot, and I expect we'll be learning a lot from the community and the stories people bring. And as we go about this process, I know this is going to be just the first of many roadshows, is your plan.
It is, yep.
Or stops in the roadshow.
Yeah, it sure is. And there will be more information. Hopefully we'll be back again sometime here with you soon and can talk to you more about what the next steps are in the process for the roadshow.
Great. I look forward to it.
All right, well, thank you again for having me here. I really appreciate it.
No, thank you, Bob. Please come out and join us on Tuesday, November 27th at 7 o'clock for the Quincy History and Heritage Roadshow at the Thomas Crane Library.